Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain about physiographic divisions of India. So I will complete these six physiographic divisions in 6 to 7 videos. So this is the second video of series of videos that I will do on geography, for specifically for UPSC prelims exam. So let's start with today's discussion. Indian landmass is divided into 6 physiographic divisions, which includes northern and northeastern mountains, northern plains, then Thar deserts in Rajasthan, then peninsula plateau region, then coastal plains, then islands, which means Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So in this video I am going to explain about northern and northeastern mountains. So northern and northeastern mountains are the Himalayas and Purvachal. Now I explain about the Himalayas first. As you seen here, the Himalayas are classified into 3 ranges. They are Greater Himalayas or Himadri, Lesser Himalayas are Himachal, and finally Outer Himalayas are Shivalik Hills. So these Himalayan ranges are having a length of 2400 km from west end to east end. Their width is more in Kashmir and their width is less towards Arunachal Pradesh. So the Great Himalayas or Himadri is the northernmost range of the Himalayan ranges. Then the Lesser Himalayas or Himachal is at the south of the Himadri. Then the Outer Himalayas or Shivalik Hills are at the south of the Himachal. Then the Himalayan ranges, other than these 3 ranges, are called as Trans-Himalayan ranges. So I will show these Trans-Himalayan ranges in the map. They include, so you need to remember these 4 Trans-Himalayan ranges in order wise, from north to south. It will be benefit for map based question. So I will, first range is Karakoram range, it is at the north. Then second, after below the Karakoram range is called Ladakh range. Then below it, Jaskar range. Then the extension of Jaskar range is called as Kailas range. So I explain these 4 Trans-Himalayan ranges in detail. The first Trans-Himalayan range is the Karakoram range. This Karakoram range is having world's second highest peak, that is K2 mountain. This K2 mountain is the India's first highest peak. So the world's first highest peak is the Mount Everest. It is in Nepal. So I will show the exact location of K2 mountain in the separate map. As you see here, this K2 mountain is at Baltistan province of Pak occupied Kashmir. This region has been occupied by Pakistan illegally. So I will show the exact location in another map. This region is the Jammu and Kashmir state. This Jammu and Kashmir state is having 3 administrative divisions, that is Kashmir, Jammu, and recently created Ladakh as a new administrative division. This Ladakh
is having two districts, that is Leh and Kargil. So just follow this line. This region is called as Pak occupied Kashmir. This region has been illegally occupied by Pakistan. So this illegally occupied region of Pakistan is having two provinces, that is Gilgit provinces and Baltistan provinces. These two provinces are combinedly known as Gilgit-Baltistan region. So one more thing, as you see here, these two regions, that is Sakhsham Valley and Aksai Chin region, these two regions are occupied by China. So the K2 mountain is in Baltistan region of Pak occupied Kashmir. The second range of Trans Himalayas is Ladakh range. As you see here, the Ladakh range is at south of the Karakoram range. The third range of Trans Himalayas is Jaskar range. As you see here, this is the Jaskar range. It is at the south of the Ladakh range. We can find Nanga Parbat in this range. And also we can find one more range here. It is known as Deosai range. Deosai range. So let me show these two peaks in separate map. As you see here, this is the Nanga Parbat. This Nanga Parbat is in Jaskar range. And also we can find Deosai range. This Deosai range is also is in Jaskar range. The last range of Trans Himalayas is Kailas range. As you see here, this is the Kailas range. It is the extension part of Jaskar range. It is in Tibet region of China. So we can find Mount Kailas here. And also we can find Lake Manas Sarovar. In this is the place where River Indus and River Brahmaputra originates. Apart from these four ranges, as I explained earlier, we can also find two more ranges in Himalayas, that includes Kanchenjunga mountain range and also Namcha Barwa mountain range. The Kanchenjunga mountain range is the third largest mountain range after Mount Everest and Mount K2. This Kanchenjunga mountain range is in Sikkim and Nepal. So one more mountain range is Namcha Barwa mountain range. This mountain range is in between Arunachal Pradesh and Tibet region of China. That is, it is on McMahon line. So the last concept of this video is Purvachal. So I explain about Purvachal mountain ranges in separate map. As you see here, this is the Purvachal ranges. This Purvachal ranges includes Indian states of Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Meghalaya. In this region, we can find many more mountain ranges. These mountain ranges play a major role in Indian northeastern monsoon. Also find small mountain ranges also, but I am listing very important mountain ranges only. That includes Patkai Bum in Arunachal Pradesh. It is in borderline of Arunachal Pradesh and Myanmar. Then second important mountain range is Naga Hills in Nagaland. Then Manipur Hills in Manipur. Then Mizo Hills in Mizoram. These mountain ranges are extended towards Arakan mountain ranges in Myanmar. And also three more important mountain ranges in Meghalaya are Garo Hill, Khasi Hill, then Jayantia Hill. This Khasi Hill is found in the capital city of Meghalaya, that is Shillong. So I am stopping this session here. In my upcoming videos, I will explain about important passes in Himalayan ranges, and also I will try to complete remaining physiographic divisions of India. Thank you.